Yo, what's good? This is St. Joe, SoundsandGear.com. Today we're checking out AEON. It's a new product from Heavyocity. Y'all know I'm a Heavyocity fanatic. So this one actually has two parts to it. There's a rhythmic part and a melodic. You can actually buy them separately, but today I'm checking out the full collection. It's a contact player library, so you don't need the full version of contact to use it. It works with the free player. So we're gonna go into the interface. I'm gonna show you around. You know they got crazy stuff going on with the effects and all that different stuff. So we're gonna check all that out, see what it sounds like. So let's get into it.
All right, so here's the interface. Really, really sick interface. This thing just looks amazing. You can see you got everything really within easy grasp. You got your twist, you can turn that up. It's kind of like a panner phaser almost type of thing. You got your different mixes for the different levels you're tuning and your different sections. Then you got the punish knob, which kind of is like a distortion. You got your effects over here. You got your different modulation type effects. You got your reverb, distortion, delay. And then you can see over here you got your different volume envelopes. You got your trigger effects right there, so you can either turn them on and actually go in and sequence those if you want, so, or you can trigger them by the keys. So it's really, really deep. Then over here you got your EQ filter, different filter LFO, all the different stuff, and you can see your arpeggiator. And I mean, it's just a lot of stuff in here, so I want to go through and really just show you how it sounds and how the different things interact. So yeah, I'm gonna just try not to do so much talking and just go through a bunch of them. If you want to see what those are doing, so those are the trigger effects. So really, really crazy stuff. All right, let's see. You got some different hybrid sounds going on. Some really, really good sounding stuff. They also have some like traditional organic type sounds in here too. One thing I want to show you about the arpeggiator is you can see right here where it says chain or single. So you got 8 different sections or 8 different patterns, and you can actually chain them together. Right now there's playing 4 patterns, and you can just chain them by moving it wherever you want it, or you can put it on single. So I wanted to show you that really quick. Like I said, there's a lot of stuff in here, so I just want to show you as much as I can. So as you can see, the sequencer is on for that effect. So like I said, it's really, really dynamic and just fun to mess around with. Just a lot of stuff in here, man. Let's see. You got some harp combos and harps going on. Yeah, I mean, it's just so much in here. You see, it still haven't gotten messed with the keys yet. You got music box stuff. So everything just has a really nice sound to it. Let's check out some strings, what they got in there. Cool, cool stuff. All right, let's see. You got, let's go into some synths. Thank you. You can see, man, there's so much stuff in here. It sounds good. You can see those, they got ARPs. So those are the automatic ARPs. It's pretty much the same stuff, but you got ARPs going on. But there's a lot of, there's actually some different stuff in there too. So I'll play a few. Like I said, pretty much these are like the synths or the organic instruments that I showed you, but they just got the arpeggiator turned on for them. So we showed you that. Let's see, and then let's show some of the rhythmic stuff. Like I said, it's, since I'm showing both of them, it's going to get a little longer, but I just want to show you as much as I can, or without taking up too much of your time. So anyway, so the menus are going to be an individual loop on each one. Really, really cool stuff. And you can see all these different menu suites. So all these different loops and different patches. And one thing I want to mention is the rhythmic stuff is not just drums. It's just rhythmic and arpeggiated type things, percussive sounds. So there's a lot of melodic stuff in here, and it's not just percussion. I know that's what I was thinking when I first saw it, but that's not what it is. So you get the idea with that. And then as you can see, I have the single loops. So what the single loops are, they're going to be chopped up. So you got the every loop from each of those menu suite patches. And then I can go in and play the individual chops for each one. So you could put effects and stuff on each one, so I can go into the advanced loop. Let's say I want to set the tune or the panning or the level of an individual slice, I can do that. You can go in and mess with the performance. You can see you got all these different presets in there you can mess with. And like I said, you got a lot of melodic stuff in there, and that's why I wanted to show you this, because I didn't want you thinking that it's just like drums and percussion, because it's not. It's actually more melodic things than drums and percussion from what I'm seeing, but there's so much stuff in here, I haven't even went through all of it yet. Let's do... there's so much stuff in here, man. So it just really, really gives you a lot of flexibility. Let's see, maybe one out of here, one or two. Like I said, lots of melodic stuff in the rhythmic package. And let's make this one the last one. See what this sounds like. All right, man. So, yeah, this interface, the whole library. I mean, Heavyocity is one of my favorite developers, and you can see why. Look at this interface. It's really, this thing is just sexy, well laid out, everything. It looks like it has texture to it. It's almost 3D, but it's not cheesy 3D. Everything just looks really nice. It's like it's got shadows on it, all that different stuff. But despite how much it looks good, it actually works well. Everything's laid out so you can quickly get in and manipulate things. Trigger effects, of course, are awesome. And being able to go in, trigger them, or go in and sequence them, that's crazy. And then, like I said, that's the rhythmic section. So, of course, you can mess with the individual slices. And then the melodic. All together, it's just a really, really dope library. I give it 5 out of 5 subs. Like I said, I'm checking out the full collection, which is $3.99. You can get them separately for $1.99 for the rhythmic and $2.99 for the melodic. I suggest going for the full collection anyway, just because it's always good to have the full thing, in my opinion, and I think they work really well together. But again, everything's laid out well, works inside of the contact player. Heavyocity, you know they always deliver when they come through with something new, so a lot of us have been waiting for this. So just wanted to let you know what was in it and kind of give you a really broad overview. So I know this got a little bit longer, but like I said, it's actually two collections, and I wanted to give you a pretty good idea of what's in both, especially that rhythmic one, because I wanted to make sure you understood that it's not just percussion and drums and stuff like that, like many of us were thinking. So again, this is the AEON collection from Heavyocity. I'm gonna give it a 5 out of 5 subs. This is St. Joe, soundsandgear.com. Let me know what you think. Rate, comment, subscribe, share the video, tell them I sent you to the site, all that good stuff.